St. Joseph murder suspect who started a gun battle with state troopers in mid-Missouri yesterday took his own life, but not before shooting up several law enforcement vehicles and wounding two men. Tonight, one of those men spoke with KMBC 9's Dan Weinbaum.
Heading home, Chris Gerke didn't know he was driving into a free fire zone. He saw a semi off the road and wondered, what's going on? And then...
all I heard is kaboom, and everything inside my truck blast got shattered out and got pulled off the side road, and I felt this pain inside my hip.
State troopers say Ty Arnold, wanted for murdering his wife earlier in the day, was firing wildly out of his truck as troopers closed in. Two bullets found Chris Gerke's truck, one blew a tire, the other punched through the door and into Gerke's hip.
No, I never thought I'd ever get shot, and it ain't. It's nothing I want to do again.
He wasn't the only one shot. The driver of the tanker truck was wounded in the head, and six law enforcement cars were shot up as well.
He had no regard for anyone's safety, whether it's law enforcement or innocent civilians.
Stop sticks disabled Anthony's truck during the chase, and when he stopped, he stepped out and looked through the scope of his rifle, pulled the trigger, and punched bullets into the troopers' cars a few hundred yards back, just missing the troopers by inches.
He made a statement to a family member that he didn't want to go to jail.
And he won't. Though troopers peppered Arnold's truck with bullets, Arnold turned a gun on himself and ended it all. Meanwhile, down the road, Chris Gerke was finding himself to be very lucky.
I'm lucky. I mean, and I could, I guess, been, he could have shot a little higher and killed me.
Dan Weinbaum reporting that troopers say Arnold was armed with both a semi-automatic handgun and a semi-automatic rifle with a large drum magazine. The investigation into the murder of his wife, Amanda Arnold, continues in St. Joseph.